AI, or artificial intelligence, is everywhere these days. There's a lot of hype around the way this technology has advanced over recent years. But what is it? Hi everyone, I'm Natalie from My Progression, and this video is all about AI, what it is, how it might shape the classroom of the future, and some challenges it may present to you as an educator. So this is part one of two videos about AI, and part two will look at how you can use it now, along with some do's and don'ts. So what is AI? AI stands for artificial intelligence. This is where a computer is able to make decisions for itself based on information it receives. If you've ever played a video game against a computer, used a device with speech recognition, or made a funny picture of your friend in the style of Picasso with an image generator, then you've been in contact with AI. AI does seem to be everywhere these days, but the concept is far older than you might think. Alan Turing, better known for his work breaking the Enigma code during World War II, is also regarded as the grandfather of artificial intelligence. He devised a test in the 1950s called the imitation game, now better known as the Turing test. In this test, a person would exchange pieces of text separated by a wall and would be asked to see if they thought they were interacting with a human or a computer. Software developers have been trying to make convincing chatbots ever since. So roll on to present day, and we're not only able to have relatively convincing chatbots, but services like ChatGPT have started creating convincing written text. Talking to a computer is no longer left in the realms of science fiction, and complex tasks that would once take days can be done in seconds with the help of AI, even medical screenings. Now we're going to take a look at the most commonly used function of artificial intelligence, generative AI. A lot of the jargon around AI can be confusing and off-putting. It might bring to mind tech bros selling you cryptocurrency. And terms like large language modules and stable diffusion mean little to most. So what does it actually do, and how could this shape the future of our classrooms? Well, imagine that instead of a computer, you've got a really clever blender. And instead of a huge amount of written information, you've got a table with a wide range of fruit and vegetables. The blender will combine different ingredients together to make you a smoothie. Now it knows that apple, strawberries, and banana work really well together, but it learned from that one time it added broccoli that that didn't go. Well, generative AI works in the same way, to mix together different sources of text or images to give you a result in seconds that would have taken a human far longer. One of the most commonly used is ChatGPT. All you need to do is type in what you want it to create, and this is known as a prompt. For example, I asked ChatGPT, write a limerick about an education video presenter called Natalie and her struggle with her computer. And this is what it came out with. There once was a teacher named Nat, whose computer would crash in a spat. She'd click and she'd freeze, then beg it with ease, just work or I'll grab a big bat. Now, if you need a model text for your class, it can create exactly what you want. You could ask it to write you a poem or a song. Maybe you have a theme or a topic your class is working with that it can incorporate. Perhaps you can differentiate for different levels of ability based on something that you've already created for the wider class. With so many different demands on teaching time, schools are actively suggesting this as a use of AI. For using AI, do check your school's policy on this. Have you used AI in your classroom or your daily life? What did you think? Pop a comment below, and whilst you're there, like, subscribe, and click on the bell to keep hearing more from My Progression. One of the most significant benefits of AI in education is its ability to provide personalised learning experiences. AI-powered platforms can tailor content to meet the individual needs of each student, allowing for differentiated instruction that accommodates different learning styles and paces. For instance, there are adaptive learning platforms that use AI algorithms to adjust the difficulty of lessons based on a student's performance, ensuring that each student is challenged at an appropriate level. This personalised approach helps students to stay engaged and motivated, as they're neither bored by material that's too easy, nor frustrated by content that's too difficult. AI can also offer targeted feedback and recommendations for further study. For example, when a student struggles with a particular concept, AI can suggest specific resources such as videos, articles, or additional practice problems to help them improve. This type of personalised feedback allows teachers to provide more individualised support without the need to manually create resources for each student, so saving time while still addressing diverse learning needs. Now, this technology does exist. It would need to be adopted by the whole school and would still need to be monitored to ensure it's working in the way that it should. Engaging students is a constant challenge in the classroom, and AI offers innovative ways to capture and maintain their interest. AI-powered educational games and interactive simulations can make learning more engaging and enjoyable. Platforms like Quizlet and Kahoot use AI to create personalised quizzes and games that adapt to each student's level, making learning fun and interactive experience. These tools can also provide instant feedback, allowing students to learn from their mistakes in real time. So virtual and augmented reality, powered by AI, but not technically AI, can further enhance engagement by creating immersive learning experiences. For example, AI can power a virtual school trip that allows students to explore historical sites, scientific concepts, or even outer space from the comfort of their classroom. These immersive experiences can help to deepen the understanding and make abstract concepts more tangible and relatable. AI can also play a crucial role in supporting students with SEND, ALN, and diverse learning requirements. For example, AI-powered tools like speech-to-text and text-to-speech applications can assist students with disabilities in accessing and engaging with classroom content. AI can also provide translation and language support for English language learners, helping them to better understand instructions and participate fully in class activities. By offering these tailored supports, AI can create a more inclusive learning environment where all students have the resources they need to thrive. The use of AI comes with its own issues, from the proliferation of fake news to spam bots and the legal implications of who owns the artwork that many image generators are sampling. You can't have escaped the news that ranges from concern all the way up to robots taking over the earth. But in amongst the more outlandish claims, there are more genuine concerns that you do need to consider when using AI in your classroom. So first, on a more minor level, a robot completing homework for your pupils is not acceptable. The good news is, at the moment, it's relatively easy to spot. For starters, with many of these tools being used in the United States, many of the spellings are in American English and words may have far more Z's in place of S's. At a basic level, David, who sat at the back of the class on Wednesday talking about the Aston Villa game during a geography lesson, has suddenly submitted a PhD level thesis for his homework on volcanoes. If it doesn't look like their work, these days it's probably AI. On another tack, if they're using AI as a research tool, there's a chance information may be factually incorrect. Google's AI was once recommending people eat rocks because they're good for you. On the more concerning end, historical and scientific answers with inaccuracies could have profound effects if taken at face value. For this reason, many AI services now carry a content warning about accuracy. AI tools in the classroom need to be supervised. The content that could be created may be wildly inappropriate for children, especially when using image generators. Image generators pose serious safeguarding risks to children when used by online predators. In 2023, the Online Safety Act was introduced and states where generative AI has been used to create an indecent or a prohibited image of a child, this should be considered illegal content. AI imagery may be used to blackmail children, and educating your class about online safety is vital. If you'd like to understand more on this, please see our video on social media safeguarding, linked in the description below. Now, whilst there are many benefits that AI can bring to the classroom, it is essential for educators to approach AI with a critical eye, understanding its limitations and ensuring it is used ethically and responsibly. As AI continues to evolve, its potential to support teaching and learning will only grow, making it an invaluable resource for the modern classroom. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, there will be a part two looking at how you can use it now, along with some do's and don'ts. If you found this video useful, then check out the rest of our channel for more on working in education. I've been Natalie from My Progression, and let's keep your career in motion.